Digital is it free or is it you pay for it?
Both.
Both, okay. So maybe I'll think about it. I messaged Akshay today.
Yeah.
And I told him, I congratulated Akshay. I said, I'm so happy for you. And he said, happy for you too. It's time we work together.
Hello everyone and welcome to Middi.com. Today I'm here with John Abraham and Nikhil Advani. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
First of all, congratulations on the film. It's been appreciated by the audience and as well as the critics. So, you know, numbers aside, what according to
Mayank Shekhar gave us a very good review.
Yeah.
I met him today in the morning and I said, Mayank, I cannot believe it that you I have finally got you to give me a good review.
Did he give me a good review?
Yeah. He said, parts, you as good as Amir Khan.
Oh, wow.
I said, Mayank, what were you having?
That's
it. So, numbers aside, you know, what according to you all, you know, determines the success of a film?
I think the audience reaction, word of mouth, people calling up, and like that there are people who I haven't spoken in 20 years, 25 years, I went to school with, they've been calling up and say that we took our children and we watched the film and they are so proud, and we are telling our children that he went to school with us, you know. So it's a very big thing for you know. Also, I mean, I think from both our, I've seen when Sanjeev Kumar Yadav and his family saw the film on Wednesday night.
Hmm.
He called up, he was in tears and he said, my family, my in-laws did not know that I was going through so much.
Okay.
And they said that, we can't believe that we had no clue that you were going through so much tension and stress and all that. So yeah, these are very important.
Shobhana and Sanjeev called me yesterday. Shobhana, Sanjeev's wife, Nandita, with Imran Khan's character.
Right.
And she said, my mother saw the film and she thinks you're better than my husband. to answer you, I think, there's a certain energy you feel when you know your film's being liked.
Yeah.
And that energy is very infectious and it just kind of keeps you alive.
Yeah.
And I think Nikhil and I, we felt it with this film when we were together, even when we're not together, when he's in the office, when I'm there, like the phone calls, like today, you know, actors were calling me and messaging me, saying heard fantastic things, and that doesn't happen. It didn't happen for my last film.
Right.
That's the best indicator,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
So, it's a very gratifying feeling.
What is the best message you received from an actor, fellow actor?
Oh, I think today I messaged Akshay today.
Yeah.
And I told him, I congratulated Akshay. I said, I'm so happy for you. And he said, happy for you too. It's time we work together. So, you know, that's nice when it's so healthy. And I think it's nice when camaraderie is so good that it's not competitive, but it's complementary. That both the films are being appreciated and. And I can speak for Batla House. People are loving every moment of it.
Right. So what was the first thing that you thought of, you know, when you signed on the script and when you became a producer and an actor in the film?
I think Nikhil was gracious enough to get me on as a producer in this film, to be very honest. But I think as an actor, it was a fantastic script.
Right.
I think the only advantage of having Nikhil Advani, a director like him on board, is he'll make the film look better than the script. So, I mean, all credit to him for, you know, crafting such a beautiful film.
Did you get a lot of inputs from others too, who probably witnessed the incident, to give you a little more information about what happened on that day?
I think Nitesh had already done about a year and a half, 2 years of research before he came to me with the script. And then, when I heard, and he said that, you know, the guy was D-Day should make this film, and you know, it's in the zone of Parmanu and D-Day. I mean, at that time he didn't say Parma, he said Madras Cafe, you should read the script, and I read the script, and my first reaction to him, or my first concern was that what have you left out? I want to know everything that you left out, because it's so complicated, and what happened post the incident, post the encounter was so complicated, and was so, had so many points of view, so many perspectives, so many people had different things to say about it.
Right.
I was very interested in understanding that, because I didn't want to be unfair to any one particular. Because at the end of the day, it is inspired from a real story. It's not it's not something that happened in 1857.
True.
It's something that happened really in our recent past.
Yeah.
You know, so there are people who could sit up and say, and I'm sure they will still say.
Hmm.
They will still say. I mean, we would just ask a question that, do you think that you've been fair to everybody? I don't know. I don't think I could be fair to anybody.
Hmm.
Somebody asked me, was this film made to give the police a clean sheet? I said, who am I to give the police a clean sheet? That is the NHRC did that, and so did the Jharkhand trial court. They are the ones who basically gave the clean sheet to the police, right? So we just followed the case. We literally followed the case.
Right. And why was it so important for you to, you know, show objectivity in the film? Like, you've shown him from all angles and, you know, all sides of the story have been explored. So, what was your take on that?
Yeah, of course it was. I mean, I tried my best.
Yeah.
There are things that were only said in hushed whispers to me, which I put completely in large sections of the film, you know. And things that were just rumored to have happened, we've actually addressed those things, whether it is rivalry, etc., etc. We've done all those kind of things.
And the film, you know, when Sanjay Kumar goes through so many issues and that emotional turmoil, you know, when people don't believe what is being said. So, in real life, how do you, you know, deal with such things that have been written about you or with media reports and things like that?
Earlier, I couldn't understand how to deal with it. Now I understand how to deal with it a lot better. So, it's just about, see, it's like saying, can you avoid stress? You cannot avoid stress. You have to learn how to deal with stress.
Perspective.
So, similarly, criticism, you have to deal with it. So, I have understood that deal with criticism in a way that you look at it as constructive.
Right.
Don't look at it as destructive. And that's how I deal with it. So, if someone says something negative, I say, maybe he's got a point, maybe she's got a point. Maybe I can do better for myself, and that's how I deal with it.
And then there are social media trolls who just go all out just to, you know, put you down. So how do you, you know,
deal with those things? So I think they usually troll films, you know, particularly if you make an irresponsible statement, or what people perceive as an irresponsible statement, they troll that. And that's what I said in my interviews earlier also. People will troll bad films, but people will debate a good film. So in a case of Batla House, I think I have not seen any of that, fortunately and thankfully. Maybe good sense has prevailed on people even with low intelligence quotient, so it's fine.
Thankfully. So,
I don't know what to say to you.
And you know, you've shown the vulnerable side also of Sanjay. So what was that like? So how did you?
Well, I think that was something that was extremely fascinating for me, because we think about soldiers and police officers as very unidimensional. They are meant to be the protectors of the law, and they just go in and they are brave and courageous and all. But you actually you cease to think that they also sometimes have second thoughts, and they think about things, they think about repercussions, they think about family, they think about what is going to happen to family if something happens to them. So I think that was extremely fascinating, you know, as just a character piece, you know. I mean, on the end of the day, a lot of people have turned around. I mean, the negative reviews that they've spoken about the film has been that I've not been able to decide between what I want to say, whether it's a character piece or whether it's plot driven. I think it's a bit of both. You know, you can't make the plot would not have taken place if it was not what he was going through and what was leading him to take those steps to finally get Dilshad from wherever he gets Dilshad. So I think it's a bit of both. I don't think you can see it. I don't think you can look at anything in isolation.
True. And you've done a romantic, you know, role in a long time, after a very long time. So what was that like?
We started shooting this film when I started shooting in Runal. The first thing was a song. So I was like a little awkward. I couldn't just, because I've not had a romantic moment with a female lead in the longest time. So it was refreshing, it was nice, and you know, Nikhil handles romance beautifully and in a very mature way. So I think we sailed through it.
Right. And above that, you started off, you know, your career with Kal Ho Na Ho and Salaam Ishq, and now you gradually moved on to these action films with reality. So what was the reason for that change over the years?
I think that, I mean, basically you take decisions. I love Kal Ho Na Ho, but Kal Ho Na Ho was more Karan's film than possibly my film, because he was the one who had written it, right? I mean, we had done Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, we had done Kabhi Khushi Kabhi in Dharma Productions, and it was a producer's decision that we needed to do a film like that. I was actually writing a thriller. Shah Rukh and I was supposed to make a thriller, like they said. So I wanted to always make a thriller, and then after Kal Ho Na Ho, then it just became Salaam Ishq, and then it became. But I think coming when I did D-Day, it really set me free. Then I did a show called POW, which again. I realized that, you know, I like to not just make films about entertainment or whatever. I want to say things in what I want to do. And so Batla was just, you know, it just fit the what I was looking for.
So do you think the movies that you've been doing over the years, like the reality-based films, have struck a chord with the audience, and you think that that is one thing that has led to the success of most of your films?
I think I've struck a chord with myself.
Yeah.
I think I've understood my where I need to come from and where I need to go. And that's very important. And if the audience sees that you have clarity about what you're doing,
true.
They hold your hand.
Right, very true. And are there any other action films in store, or will we get to see another
side?
Yeah,
right. It starts so in middle in the early
Nikhil and I are joined by the hip now.
Yeah.
So
yeah, in that I don't know how many tires we'll have to tear, but we'll have to tear some stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Some
right.
serious
we'll have to
tearing.
Some serious tearing,
breaking.
Yeah.
And John, since a lot of actors these days have, you know, made their foray into the digital world, do you intend on doing so anytime soon?
Digital is it free or is it you pay for it?
Both.
Both. Okay. So maybe I'll think about.
If you get him to say yes, I know three digital platforms that will pay him a lot of money to
of
say
course
yes.
Will, of course. And lastly, you know, John, a few years ago, there was this video of your house where, you know, they're taken through, I think, through Asian paints. And I've seen a lot of Buddhism books in that.
Yeah.
Is that something you practice?
Yeah, I chant and I believe in the power of, I'm a spiritual person.
Yeah.
And I think there's a lot of power in doing that.
Right.
And I feel at peace. Yeah.
And has that changed you over the years?
It's mainly, it gives me my me time.
Right.
But I do it only for like 5 minutes.
Okay.
Because I don't have any me time, so those
right.
are my 5 minutes.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you
so much.
Thank
it was
you.
So nice
thank
talking
you.
To
thank
you.
Thank
you.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.